There is something wrong with our view of the world. We grew up looking at the world map that is completely misleading about the actual size of the countries and the continents. The world probably doesn't look like the way you think it does, and that matters a lot. Good day, friends. This is Avijit, and today we'll be discussing how we compromise on size and shape of a three-dimensional Earth when we try to transform it in a flat two-dimension. If you are new to this channel, welcome. Here I discuss about the basics of the offshore surveying in simple language. So let's get started. Since ancient times, we have tried to capture and recreate the world around us. With progressing technology, our map making has significantly improved from ancient times. Today I'm going to show you some of the techniques that we use to create a 2D map and what are the main problems that we have to accept and live with that. This is a 3D Earth. This is as close as I can get of a real thing. The center line you see is our equator, and the vertical line you see is our prime meridian, which is running pole to pole. Let's flatten the Earth. So how do I go about it? How do I flatten it? Let's see. Oh no, this is not the way to flatten the Earth. I completely messed up the orange. Let's try again, shall we? So here is my second Earth. Again, I got the center line, which is our equator, and the vertical line, which is our prime meridian. I also have other parallel lines or the longitude lines. Please excuse the dog barking. So let's see if I can make some cuts into it and if I can flatten the Earth without smashing it first. So I cut it into it, so let's unfold it. And here is my beautiful orange. Now if I arrange them face down, I can almost make them flat, right? So this is my flat Earth. So does it look like a flat Earth? It's in pieces. But there are some gaps on the northern half and on the southern half. But the center positions are matching, right? So to cover the northern and southern half, we need to stretch the top and the bottom, right? So that they matches perfectly. Otherwise, if you see, they're not matching perfectly. They're matching at the equator, but not at the southern half and at the northern half. So all the countries and the continents on the northern portion and on the southern portion needs to be stretched more than that they should be, so that the maps are perfectly flat. So let's see a map and let's understand what is the problem here that we are facing. So we have this nice beautiful round Earth from the Google map, and if we peel it, same like the orange, it will look similar to this. Here we see discontinuity between the countries, and that's not good, is it? So what do? We stretch the countries and fill the gap. And now we have a stretched and compromised map of the Earth. It looks great and beautiful, but the size of the countries in the north have increased manifold. Let's now look at the true sizes of the countries. Greenland is not so big after all. In the map, it seems as big as the African continent, but in truth, it is just a fraction of Africa. Mighty Russia is big, but it does not cover the entire globe. Similarly, Canada and USA does seem big in the map, but it is not so. Antarctica, which seems to occupy the entire southern half of the map, is little bigger than Australia and comparable to South America. So all these modern maps that adorn our wall are completely misleading about their true sizes of the countries that are not on the equator. But how do we make these maps? How do we flatten a 3D Earth onto a 2D shape? It is not as simple as me smashing an orange or cutting it open to flatten it. There are some mathematics, but I won't take you there because I myself hardly understand the complex mathematics. Let's do some simple explanation. The science behind transforming a 3D Earth into a 2D shape is called a projection. You have seen projection in a theater hall, haven't you? Similar to the theater hall, a projection in this case needs three elements: a light source, an object that needs to be projected, and a screen or a paper on which the projected object is to be printed. Let's learn projection, shall we? So we have our light, and we have our homemade globe, though transparent, made out of the fish ball, and we have the piece of paper or the screen on which we are going to project the features of the globe. So let's switch off the light. So there are mainly three types of projection. The first type of projection is called a planar projection, where we put a piece of paper, plain sheet of paper, at the side of the globe, and then we put a light inside the globe, and all the features of the globes are then projected on the piece of paper. That's a planar projection. The second type of projection is a conical projection, where we make a cone out of that same piece of paper, and then we put it on top of the globe so that all the features of the globe are now projected on the piece of paper. And then we take out the cone and we then unfold the cone to make a 2D map of our Earth. And the third most common type of projection is called a cylindrical projection. So we make a cylinder and then we put it on top of the globe. And everything is then projected onto the piece of paper. And then we take out the cylinder and we unfold the cylinder to make a 2D Earth. So that is how we do our projection. There are many different variations of this same projection. The cylindrical projection is the most preferred projection. In my upcoming video, I'll talk more about this cylindrical projection. You have already seen the orange peel Earth. That is one of the most popular projection that we have. So if you do not want to miss that video, please make sure that you subscribe to my channel. Till then, be good, ask questions, and always be curious.